Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm very excited to start record this series of lessons about market research. But before I gonna explain you and show you how I do my market research, I wanna explain the idea behind the method so it will be more understandable when you're gonna see it. So let's start. What is the process when we want to list an item? First, we need to understand what are we doing. If we are doing dropshipping, what kind of products are we going to look for? Yes, you're right, we're gonna look for dropshipping products. Now, let's explain briefly what is a dropshipping product. I like to define it by two definitions: generic items and small items. Generic item, it's mean general and simple item. I wanna explain it by example. Let's take this Amazon bestseller in power tools and hand tools. Now, for example, this knife is very, very simple and generic. This pocket knife is very simple and generic. This micro cutter, this screwdriver, also very, very simple and generic. But if we look on this product, this utility wet / dry vacuum, it's not that simple, and of course it's not generic. Now, for the example, if I type in AliExpress, I already type it, a pocket knife, you see I can find 27,000 result. If I type in AliExpress utility vacuum, I don't know what is it, but I didn't get any result to related to this product. So when we try to look products, we want to do it fast, we want to do it easy, so we're going to look for simple items and general items. Another example, if I gonna type this Wheatstone knife, let's type Wheatstone knife or sharpening stone, it's also can be okay. Let's see if how many results we're gonna get. We get about 6,000 results. Now, if we're gonna type something like this drill kit, I say it's cordless, you see, let's do like that, cordless drill kit, cordless. You see, again, we don't get something that about 1,000 results, it's not bad, but a lot of that not related. This one, it's kind of related. This one also, this one, it look very, very simple, so it cannot compete with this one, of course, and it's DeWalt, it's very known and popular brand. So as I said, generic item, it's simple and general item that we can find a lot of alternatives in AliExpress in very small amount of time. The second definition, it's small item. When I say small item, I do not mean just to very, very small and tiny items like poppy pins or iPhone cables. I mean items up to 2 kilos that the logistic and the shipping rate gonna be very cheap, and what kind of products we will be avoid of. First, we're gonna avoid for products with sizes. Never, 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 we do not upload products with sizes. Never mind how accurate the size chart will be, all the time will be mistakes, and we have to take care of these mistakes. And also we will not upload a complicated electronics like printers or GPS or something like that, because it's source of future problems and we do not want to deal with this. Okay, after we understand what are we looking for, it will be much more easy to start look for that. Now, very, very important thing, when we are doing market research, in any phase of the process, we do not want to be innovative, we do not want to reinvent the wheel, we just want to find what is already sold with proof to that. I mean, we don't want to look for some new products or some innovative products. We want to look for products that already sold in eBay and we have proof it's hot, and we want to find some similar good and cheaper alternative and upload to our store. So if we are looking for dropshipping products, where we can find a lot of that kind of products? Yes, you're right again, in dropshipping stores. In the next lesson, we will learn how to find very quick and easy a lot of dropshipping sellers that gonna give us a lot of idea what we can sell in our stores. So see you in the next lesson, guys.